most anterior cruciate ligament tears are acute traumatic injuries. So the symptoms occur with a sporting event or an accident, and the symptoms are acute pain, swelling, discomfort, inability to ambulate or walk. The most common history a patient gives with an anterior cruciate ligament tear is participating in a cutting or twisting sport. They plant their foot, I felt my knee twist and pop, and I was unable to continue playing basketball. However, the symptoms are variable. There are patients that tear their anterior cruciate ligament. They can continue to play four quarters of a football game or continue to ski all day. However, that is rare. The amount of swelling or pain usually precludes the athlete from continuing in their sport. Darla is an elite level martial art athlete who actually injured her anterior cruciate ligament less than 24 hours ago. This is what an acute anterior cruciate ligament tear looks like. And what you see is a normal left knee that's straight on the bed without swelling. The right knee is puffy. As I blot the knee, it's filled with blood. She has 40 or 50 cc's of blood in the knee. You can barely make out the landmarks of her patella. She can bend the knee up to 70 degrees before she begins to have pain like a water balloon. It won't bend further. The classic test to determine anterior cruciate ligament integrity is called a drawer test. Resting over my knee in a position of comfort, I apply a posterior force, and one could see the knee come forward like a drawer. It's like a drawer in a dresser. She tore her medial collateral ligament, which attaches the femur to the tibia right here, which is the ligament that connects the femur bone to the shin bone, and it's disrupted in its mid-substance. So she has a terrible triad, an ACL tear, a medial meniscal tear, and a medial collateral ligament, which will heal on its own. The meniscus will not. Many patients will ask, will their knee ever be normal? What's the success rate of an anterior cruciate ligament tear? The problem is no anterior cruciate ligament tears are identical. And the prognosis is often predicted by the collateral damage. What other structures of the knee were damaged? Fortunately, when you tear your ACL, everybody focuses on the ACL. It's the dramatic injury. I tore the ACL. Frankly, as orthopedic surgeons, we don't worry about the ACL too much. We can give you a new one. We actually replace the anterior cruciate ligament. We don't reconstruct it. We don't tie it together. We have to give you a new ligament. And if you tear it again, we can give you a second ligament or a third ligament, although that's not desirable. But what really predicts the future of an anterior cruciate ligament tear is what other structures you tore, like the meniscus, the little shock absorbers in the knee. We are not as readily able to reproduce or replace the meniscus. So if you damage your meniscus and part of it has to be removed, that's removed permanently and increases your risk of arthritis and failure of your anterior cruciate ligament. So the factors are not only the anterior cruciate ligament tear, but how much associated damage you did to the lining cartilage or the meniscal cartilage in the knee. The posterior cruciate ligament is the other robust, strong ligament connecting the thigh bone or the femur to the proximal tibia or the shin bone. It's easily seen as this black cord-like rope structure in continuity from the femur to the tibia. Contrast that to the torn or the pathologic anterior cruciate ligament, which can be seen as a black, thick cord structure, and then it tapers off to a gray area and then nothing on the femoral side. This is the tear, like a black cord that has retracted. It is not in continuity, unlike the posterior cruciate ligament that we initially saw.